What you are looking at is incredibly recent footage taken of the actively erupting Iwo Jima volcano in Japan on November 22nd. And yes, I am referring to the Iwo Jima, which was the site of the infamous World War II battle. Despite many sites, including some military history sites, incorrectly claiming that this volcano is dormant or extinct, you can see for yourself that it is still quite active. In this specific clip, courtesy of RyanH, you can see a brand new volcanic island with an almost horseshoe-like shape. This unnamed new island breached the surface on October 30th of 2023 and has been continuously erupting ever since. In the several weeks since, this ash-rich island has seemingly expanded closer and closer to the main island, suggesting that it may eventually merge with it. While a white plume simply represents boiled seawater and the ions within it which were heated by shallow magma, the black plume represents fragmenting rock, lava, and ash being ejected. These multicolored black and white plumes, which often occur at shallow island or shallow submarine volcanoes, are referred to as Sertsayan eruptions, which, as the name implies, was named after the style of volcanic eruption the Iceland island of Surtsey underwent between 1963 and 1967. Sertsayan eruptions are often far more violent than would be expected from a volcanic eruption their size, as every single explosion is amplified by the almost endless water in the oceans. Despite this fact, the ongoing eruption of Iwo Jima has so far been fairly weak, never emitting an ash plume above 1,000 meters in height. Yet, because ash is being emitted, and more than 10,000 but less than 1 million cubic meters of material has been emitted, the ongoing eruption would so far best fit on the 0 to 9 volcanic explosivity index as a 1. The world's newest volcanic island is centered 3,700 meters east and 700 meters north of Mount Suribachi, which itself is a cinder cone located on the western end of Iwo Jima Island. The newly formed island is located at the same spot where several prior eruptions occurred in 1982, 2001, 2021, and 2022, meaning it represents some form of a semi-dominant vent on the overall volcanic complex. While the unnamed island had grown to cover 5 acres by November 3rd, at that time it only had a shape of an oval. This island has now grown to cover 9.33 acres as of November 24th, currently having a dimensions of 490 meters long, 290 meters wide, and with a summit that stands at 12 meters above sea level. This summit area has been largely destroyed by frequent explosions, resulting in what used to be a solid mass now separated into two halves with a crater in the center. I hypothesize that the reason this island experienced such a drastic change in shape relates to the probability that it erupted some form of lava flow. This lava flow was viscous and did not travel very far, but created a small layer of material far more resistant to erosion than the ash the island is primarily composed of. Since the dominant wave action causes waves to move perpendicular to the shoreline, this has pulled existing loose ash on the sides of the volcano where lava is not present closer towards the shoreline in two distinct lobes. While the longer of these two lobes is now only 282 meters away from the shoreline, I am not yet of the opinion that it will definitely connect with the main island. However, if this eruption were to continue at the same low intensity for 2 more years, and the island somehow still remained by then, the overall area would be uplifted by the continued buildup of magma at depth that, this alone, would connect the two islands. As, since the end of World War II, much of the island of Iwo Jima has risen by as much as 62 feet or 18.9 meters. In recent years, the yearly rate of uplift has sometimes even exceeded 1 meter or 3.3 feet. This uplift has likely been ongoing at a fairly high rate for at least the last 500 years, as when Iwo Jima was first spotted in the 16th century, there were only 2 separated small islands. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and leave a comment below. I would also like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.